Dearly beloved brothers, sisters, and friends, we shall rise now to take our opening hymn, TSP 141, TSP 141. Thank you. Our second hymn is TSB 93. TSB 93. Almighty and everlasting Father, thou who dwellest in eternal majesty in the heaven of heavens, we bow before thee in humility and fear. For before the mountains were brought forth, before thou from the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou hast been our hiding place in all generations. We thank thee for the multitude of thy loving kindness on us through the years. We beseech you, Heavenly Father, to send us the Holy Spirit to direct us in all we shall do and say, insofar as this prayer meeting is concerned, so that we may be edified thereby as to continue to grow in the righteousness for our abundant blessings in this world and salvation in the third world, all by thy grace through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hail Jehovah and Jesus Christ.
Hail Jehovah and Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Members and friends, we're indeed highly appreciative of the mercies of God on us and giving us enablement to be in this prayer meeting. We should remember that today is Wednesday. We have our midweek Bible study meeting online coming up from 5 to 6 p.m. local time. We shall now go to our Bible reading for today, today being Wednesday, April 17, 2024. The text goes thus, quote, "For do I now persuade men or God, or do I seek to please men? For if I yet pleased men, I should not be the servant of Christ." Unquote. Galatians chapter 1, verse 10. Comment. The work of God should not be done with the mind of wanting to be praised by individuals, because that would be tantamount to doing eye service. Rather, whatever activity we do in the work of God should be done from our heart, with the goal of pleasing Him and not mortal men. In this regard, St. Paul admonished, the quotation, "And whatsoever ye do it heartily, as to the Lord and not unto men, knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive the reward of the inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ." Going further, he said, quote, "Not with eye service, as men pleasers, but as the servants of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart, with good will doing service, as to the Lord and not to men." Unquote. Colossians chapter 3, verses 23 and 24. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 6 to 8. We're still on the theme, good heart condition in God's service. What we're saying is that for us to have good heart condition in the service of God, we should not be men pleasers. We should speak the truth always. This tendency to please men has been the bane of the churches. Because they want to please men, they introduced pagan practices, purely pagan practices, into the church. They want to gain acceptance. They want recognition. They want favor from people. They want large congregation. They want a lot of money. They introduce pagan practices. And then they look for Bible citation to support such falsehood. Because they want to please men, they have allowed women to preach. They allowed women standards. So we should avoid this. Because they want to please men, they have allowed homosexuality. They said God allows it, contrary to the scriptures. Instead of warning people to desist from such things, preach to them what they would like to hear. As Apostle Paul stated in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 to 4. They'll go to people who preach to them what of the natural Jews. As in Isaiah chapter 30, verses 9 and 10. Isaiah 39 and 10. That these people, they even ask the priests, the seers, the prophets, to preach to them right things. That is, things that are acceptable to them. That even if it means deceit, you should preach that one. They don't want truth. Now, the danger in not preaching the truth is that you suffer sin upon the person. You allow sin and lawlessness to thrive. Then, Apostle Paul tells us in 1 Timothy 5, verse 22, that when you fail to condemn evil, you become a partaker of that person's sin. That's the danger in it. So, God Almighty does not have regard of persons. He loves those who do His will, but does not have respect of persons. That is because of this person who failed to apply the standards He has already stated. Our Lord Jesus Christ does not have respect of persons. And the leaders of the Jews in those days confess this. If you go to Mark chapter 12, verse 14. And the apostles now of Christ, they themselves told the religious leaders in those days that they ought to obey God rather than men. Acts 5, 28, 29. We should apply this principle always. Bible says we should buy the truth and not sell it. Hold fast to the truth always. Therein lies our blessings. We shall now rise to take doxology. That is TSP 187, part 2. TSP 187, part 2.
Thank you.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom has come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive them that trespass against us, and leave us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Jehovah and Jesus Christ.
Hail Jehovah and Jesus Christ.